on your world of the three zeros, the third zero, you've talked about poverty, zero poverty, zero unemployment, the third zero, zero net carbon emission. How do you achieve that?
Again, it's something that it took 42 years now. The whole world is fighting for that, to make the people aware. When the first people who were talking about climate change and climate challenge, everybody thought these are loonies, these are crazy people, they don't understand anything. It was a hard time to even mention that. But it took time, people start taking it seriously and more seriously, to the extent 42 years later, we came to Paris and the whole world signed an agreement that we have to act, make sure we do not cross the point of no return. Before that, we fix it up. And so unfortunate, the most important country in the whole world suddenly says, we are not part of it. Usually people were worried that China will not be part of it, India will not be part of it. They will say, well, you had your day, you did all the pollutions. When it came to our day, when we had to develop, we had to move on, you restrict everything. We don't listen to you. We do our pollution, we achieve all the goals that you have done after, with the same pollution that you did, and then we'll think about that. They became the leader of climate change. China became a staunch supporter of that. India became a staunch supporter of that. But the leading nation who is supposed to create this opinion consensus to the world step out in giving a very wrong signal. In informal way, he said it's a hoax. So you kind of take it away. So that's a kind of thing. Our piece in the book that I'm saying, not only we need that global framework, also we need individual framework. Everybody can do that. How to do address that issue? We can look at our lifestyle. What do we do? What kind of things we consume? So we don't. If we decide we don't consume things which harm the planet, which is based on fossil fuel, which is based on creating carbon emissions and so on, we don't want to touch that. We want to redesign our life. Then the world will be a good place. And we teach our children, learn from school, or learn during the school period, we would like to build our life in future as individual, a life which we will enjoy and let everybody else enjoy. We will not take away enjoyment of other people in other parts of the world because we want to enjoy our life. So that we kind of synchronize our enjoyment with their enjoyment. While we enjoy, some countries will be underwater, will go and finish. Bangladesh will be, half of the country will go underwater, slide into water with a huge population, 160 million people, and have no place to go. So that's not what I want to contribute, because it's not, Bangladesh is creating the problem for themselves. The globally problem is created, and we become the victims of it. So that's a challenge that we see. We create our own way. At the social business, we try to create a global awareness. First one we did, we created an energy company. We call it Grameen Energy or Grameen Shakti, to do a kind of thing that people thought it's a crazy thing to do, but we went ahead because we thought it's an important thing. There's no electricity in the village in Bangladesh. And Bangladesh is nothing but a collection of villages all around. So 80,000 villages make up the Bangladesh. And there's no electricity. So we thought, why don't we bring renewable energy before the fossil fuel energy comes in, which will take some time to come. So we have some respite before we can get in. So we did that. We created the company to bring solar home system. Everybody thought it will not work. It's too expensive for people in the village. They cannot afford to do that. It was really hard time to explain to people what we are trying to do. But still we believe that it can be done because it makes so much sense. Even the expert says it will not work in Bangladesh. It's good for USA or North America or Europe, but not good for Bangladesh. I said, we'll try. No harm in trying. So we tried. Even selling 4 or 5 solar systems per month became such a struggle, but we did. And then we moved to 10 solar home systems, 20 solar home systems. 15 years later, now it is 22 years, 15 years after the company is created, we are selling 1,000 solar home systems per day. It became so popular. The message that we give, whatever amount you spend on your kerosene, because you are spending on kerosene, don't tell me that you are poor. Whatever you are spending, give it to me every month. I give you solar home system right today. And for 3 years, you do exactly the same. Every month, you pay your solar, same amount that you did in the beginning. Every month, same amount. In 3 years' time, nothing will be, you have to pay anymore. All the system is yours. You are not paying to anybody. You're not paying to the kerosene. You're not paying to solar company, nobody else. It's all yours. And it made enormous sense to people. People say, hey, why don't you get it? It's so simple. So it is split. Today, we have nearly 2 million homes with solar energy by Grameen Shakti already. And by the middle of it, all it, when we're selling 1,000 per month solar system, per day per solar system, we become the largest off-grid power system in the whole world. Mm-hmm. Because nobody else is doing it. And we are the only one doing it. And we did it as a social business. We cover our costs. It's not a free, it's not a charity. We cover our costs, move on to the next, we get expand. And now many other companies sprang up in Bangladesh. Totality of it right now, nearly 4 million homes with solar energy. So this is one way, just an example what initiative individuals can take, make it happen. Now we are addressing the question of plastic. Plastic is going to put us into plastic graves because we don't breathe anymore with that. Whole plastic ocean is being created right next to the West Coast here, between Japan and West Coast. A huge area of plastic, nothing but plastic. And these plastic particles gradually start moving into other directions. Fish eat those plastics, think that these are food, and that plastic goes into their stomach. They cannot digest it. We catch the fish, we eat them, that comes into our system. And the water, in many cities now, water is having microfibers of plastic into the water system. So gradually it becomes more and more pronounced. So what we are doing, we're trying to recycle this plastic. We cannot eliminate it right away. We want to recycle it. So we take Mekong River in Vietnam as a case, build up a whole system of social business along the bank of the river, and set up little recycling plants along the way. Pick up all the plastic. Because Mekong River is getting clogged with plastics. In many rivers in the world, it's happening that way. So we collect them as a commercial enterprise, as a social business enterprise. We buy from people so that people go and catch everything that they get and sell it to us. And we convert it, made into long duration plastic elements, things like furnitures, housing elements, so that poor people can have nice houses with the plastic elements into that. So this is the beginning. We are having a big conference on plastic so that we can recycle the plastic, make it instead of end up in the ocean, it stays with us rather than run away. And then working with the researchers in the labs and everywhere, in the company, big labs, how to make biodigestible plastics. So that is the ultimate solution, because now it's not biodegradable, so creating all the, it's not destructive. It doesn't destroy itself. So this is one item. There are many other items that waste, total waste. We do such a wasteful way, and it harms our climate, because you have to produce it before you waste. We throw away waste. Just to give one example, it's elaborately discussed in my book. 30% of the vegetables grown in all over Europe, 30% of the vegetables are thrown away. After it's grown, it's a fresh vegetables and so on, thrown away. And in the vegetable industry, it is known as ugly vegetable. Can you guess why they throw away? Because they don't look good. Either the cucumber is too fat on the one side and the too thin on the other side. In the supermarket, all the vegetables, they explained to me, all the vegetable has to be in military formation. Look exactly the same. Same color, same size, same if it is a little bit shape differences, people don't buy. So we have to throw it away. So it's a huge 30% of the total vegetables. So one of our social business initiators, who is a big company, McCain, is a Canadian company. It has other stories of social business. They thought, why don't we make it a social business? They created the whole social business to buy up all these throwaway ugly vegetables. And a very simple idea. The moment profit making is removed from your mind, your eyes start seeing things which you never saw before. Suddenly you saw, this is a good opportunity, because money making is done, finished, it's not in the mind. You're seeing how to solve the problem. They created a company, big company, buy up all this, throw away ugly vegetables, chop them up, and put them into a little package, ready to cook vegetables. When you chop them off, your shape is gone. You see, shape matters everywhere, even in the vegetables. So this is how you address all these issues. Just put some examples.
Absolutely brilliant. And another really interesting thing is, if you go to Dr. Yunus's site and Grameen's site and social business, you will see a massive amount of American companies, all types of companies from almost every country in the world that are a part of the social business. And it's from Intel to other types of companies that have partnered with Dr. Yunus to really try to cause a social positive change through there, which is very impressive. And I know the list goes on and on and on, and it should go on for infinity.
It will go longer. We'll have lots of CEOs here. So we have social business on the side. You don't have to disrupt your conventional business. All you have to do is start a new business, small business. It doesn't have to be big, but a challenging new business. You feel thrilled about it, that you addressed an issue which was never addressed before. And you have that creative power to make it happen. If you make it happen, the whole world will come to you to learn and make it happen. Because it's a business, anybody can do it. All you have to do, show the way, show the path. Then everybody discuss, hey, this is fantastic. It solved the problem of unemployment. It solved the problem of global waste. It solved the problem of healthcare. It solves the problem of housing, whatever you address yourself. And all these companies are doing similar things, small business, social business, but addressing a very fundamental issue that we face. So that once you can establish that it can be done in a social business way, meaning we're not interested in making money, but make sure it is serve the purpose of the company by solving the problem. The problem doesn't exist anymore. So anybody can do that. That's the point. It doesn't have to be somebody else. Any one of us. Even if you're not investing in it, come with an idea. Idea is the big power. If you have the idea, somebody say, hey, this is a great idea, I'm going to invest in it. And we do that.